between life and death, more than 2 million Palestinian people in the besieged coastal enclave are reeling in the Gaza Strip amid the continuing of the war between the ethnic Hamas movement and the Israeli army in the coastal enclave for the 6 months in a row, amid the absence of any signs of reaching a humanitarian ceasefire between Hamas and Israel shortly. Now, we are standing in front of a home residential house that was bombed an Israeli warplane that attacked over the heads of its residents, killing a number of them and wounding others. Here in Gaza, hearing huge explosions resulted by the Israeli warplanes and attacks in the besieged coastal enclave became somehow normal for Palestinians. Mostly, the attacks took place during the night, but once the sun rises in the coastal enclave, mainly in the Rafah city, dozens of thousands of people rushed to the local streets and to the local markets to obtain some of their basic needs that they are really need to them for their family during the holy month of Ramadan. The ability here in Gaza and in the Rafah city, the site of bombing and scattering of body parts has become somewhat familiar due to the continuing Israeli attacks. The Israeli army in its daily statement that it said that they targeted the Hamas and the Palestinian Islam Jihad facility, and sometimes they attacked activists in the post part the post movement. But the locals in Gaza accused Israel that it only attacked their properties and only killed the innocent Palestinians in the besieged coastal enclave. As soon as we walk in the streets of the cities of the Gaza Strip, we can see hundreds and sometimes thousands of destroyed homes that were often targeted. Furthermore, Palestinians complain that they are fairly able to buy even the slightest bit of their basic needs for their families. During this Ramadan, the Palestinians live experience unlike what they used in the previous years. They only celebrated Ramadan with the absence of meat and poultry for their breakfast tables. Preparing this dessert dishes have become also a part of imagination. In the markets, we can see a lot of goods and a lot of sweets, and even sometimes a lot of breads and vegetables. But the people really, they cannot buy them because most of them now live under the line of poverty that resulted from the war in the besieged coastal enclave. They don't have work, and they don't have anything or any income source to let them purchase their basic needs. You can see here also some wounded people who come here for the Rafah market. Maybe just to see and to oversee the situation here. Without we can see now some dealers and vendors who are present in the economy. The people don't have enough money for them. During our conversation with a number of people here in Rafah City, they said that they fear real famine will invade them and kill them. And their children before the Israeli army even begins its military operation in the Rafah City, mainly amid the ongoing threats issued by Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu, who insists on implementing to eliminate Hamas and the Islamic Jihad in the coastal enclave. in another aspect of daily life. In the early hours of the day, other Palestinians rush towards water filling centers, fighting among themselves for a place in long lines to fill a few gallons with potable water for their families, while some of them run towards associations and civil institutions to obtain some boxes of food that are fairly sufficient for their children for 2 days or even sometimes for 3 days only. Such a tragic life that Palestinians live. Such a tragic life that Palestinians live, and is the result of the continuation of the military conflict between Hamas and Israel since the civilians of last October. After Hamas launched its unprecedented and sudden attacks at the military site, as well as the Israeli towns adjacent to the coastal enclave, and killed about 1,200 people, including foreign and dual citizens inside Israel. In addition, it kidnapped about 250 others inside Gaza. Since then, Israel has launched its large-scale war against the Hamas in the coastal enclave, killing about 32,000 Palestinians and wounded more than 73,000 others. In addition, about 80% of Palestinian homes and facilities were destructed by the Israeli army in the coastal enclave, which displaced more than 30% of Palestinians to the central and the southern part of the coastal enclave. Most of them, they live now in Rafah city, as some of them live in dozens of thousands of temporary tents set up in the Rafah city, while others fled to the schools that belonging to the United Nations Relief and Works Agency for Palestinian refugees, as they believe that maybe such places would be protected by the Israeli army and it will not be able to attack, being attacked by the army. Now we are working in, as I said, in a local market in the Rafah city, and we can see that some people are trying to buy some food while others just walking for the walking or maybe to play and escape from their children who are asking them all the time to get food for themselves. It's so important for Palestinians to have some ceasefire in the Mizik coastal enclave to allow them to deal with the tragic situation that resulted from the war in the Mizik coastal enclave, mainly as the Israeli army is threatening all the time that they will absolutely invade Rafah city, the last city in the besieged coastal enclave that's housing more than 1.5 million Palestinians, most of them beautiful. In our cameras now we can see some houses who are housing now dozens of thousands of Palestinians, and who complain all the time that they don't have any chance to flee from the death in Rafah if the Israeli army really implements its threat of invading the coastal enclave. We are now walking towards a school that's belonging to the UNRWA to see and to check the situation there and how the people live inside it. We can see all the time that such a school is crowded with the displaced people who even don't know to find other places to live inside prison. All the time they are lake, they are suffering from the lack of water, from the lack of housing requirements inside their classrooms that became out of the schools. Now we can see some tents that start placed here on the road, and are housing now tens of Palestinian people. Marhaba, Palestinian people who mostly come. We can ask them now.
الله العظيم يا رب.
شو بدي اول شغله تعرفيني عن اسمك ومن وين نزحتي وقديش صار لك موجوده هنا في رفح؟
انا من قطاع غزه من حي الزيتون والي 5 شهور هنا، 5 شهور بالعدل. واسمي سميحه عبد العال مصطفى دادر. وهيني هنا مره مريضه وشايفه الحياه كلها زي الزفت. بدنا نروح على بلادنا، يعني احنا بدنا نروح على بلادنا احسن لنا، يعني بلا معنى. انت شايفه انا الصنه والقرف والدنيا والدين، وانا مره مريضه مش متحمله كل هالدنيا هذه، تعبانه معايا القلب ومعايا مرض الكبد الوبائي ومعايا غضروف في ظهري 4 زردات ومعايا ضغط، يعني من جميعها الحمد لله رب العالمين. وهينا مصطبرين على حكم ربنا وبدنا نروح على بلادنا، يروحونا على بلادنا. واللي بدهم يعملوا، احنا ما في حاجات هذه الحكومه بين بعض احنا ما بنقدرش نتدخل فيها. المهم بس يروحونا على بلادنا، بنتريح. صحيح لا صالحه لسكن ولا لزراعه ولا لحاجه ولا محتاجه، بنقعد في خيم، نقعد في الخيم في بلادنا. المهم في بلادنا، وزي ما حطونا في اماكن امنه يروحونا في مكاننا امنه، في بلادنا امنه. هاي اللي بنطلبه من الله.
طيب ايش بتطالب العالم يا حجه؟ وكمان
انا بطالب العالم، بناشد كل العالم، الدول العربيه والاجنبيه وكل الدول اللي الله خلقها، تفرجها علينا وتقف معانا وتروحنا على بلادنا. ومعي بكفي كتر حرب، عمرنا في الحياه ما شفنا حرب زي الحرب. كورانيا وهذيك اللي كانوا يحاربوا مع بعض 2 سنين ما عملوش فيهم زي ما عملوا فينا، قتلوا اولادنا وقتلوا وهدموا دورنا وما خلوناش حاجه في الدنيا كلها، ظلمونا والله ظلمونا كثير. ايش نسوي يعني في هالحياه؟ معي اولادنا اللي راحوا، معي دورنا اللي راحت، صارت من سواد الارض. وهنا قاعدين، جوز راح وجوز بنت راح وجوز بنت راح، كلهم راحوا، اولادنا واولاد عائلتنا كلها. ايش نسوي يعني في هالحياه؟ اكثر من هيك الطاقه مش سايعه يا بنت، مش طايقه صدرنا، صار مش طايق الحياه اللي احنا عايشينها والغلب اللي احنا عايشين فيه. المعلبات اللي بدنا اياها عملت معنا امراض، صرنا سهل ونتج، كل سهل ونتج امراض. ايش نعمل؟ هذه حياه، هذه عيشه. حرام عليهم، حرام عليهم الدول يقفوا معانا، يشوفوا عيشتنا، يشوفوا حالنا، يشوفوا الغلب اللي احنا فيه. ايش نعمل؟ وهذا حياه الدنيا هيك مر علينا. والله رمضان اجانا ما احنا حاسين فيه ولا عارفين انه رمضان، والله بتيجي الجمعه ما احنا عارفينها ولا عارفين رمضان من شوال، من جمعه، من سبت، حد الله ما احنا عارفين من كثر الهم اللي احنا فيه. ايش نعمل؟ وربنا الحمد لله يرحمنا برحمته، احنا طالبين الرحمه من الله، الرحمه منك يا رب، مش من العبد، الرحمه من ربنا هو سبحانه وتعالى. واحنا صايمين، انا بدعي لله يرحمنا ويعفينا ويعفي عنا وريحنا من هالحياه يا بوت يا بحياه، ريحنا من هالحياه يا بوت يا بحياه.
We talked with a displaced woman who lived in El Zaitoun neighborhood in the south of Gaza City, and she displaced from her house and came here to the Rafah city to set up a temporary tent in this area 4 months ago. This woman said that she's suffering all the time from the consequences of the war, mainly as she suffers from diseases like heart and depression, and she cannot find any medical or any medicine for herself. In addition, she said that she lost her husband during the war, her sons, and also her son-in-law during Israeli attacks. She called on the international community and the Arab countries to pressure Israel to stop its war and to allow her at least to come back to her house, even if she will establish another tent, but she will be happy to establish her new tent over the range of her house in the Zaitoun neighborhood. Now we are trying to talk to another vendor inside the local market to know his opinion of the current situation in Gaza. مرحبا.
احكي لي بالله اسمك.
هاني الشاعر من رفح.
هاني احكي لي كيف الوضع موجود هنا في رفح.
والله الحمد لله، نسال الله ان شاء الله ربنا يفرج علينا الوضع هذا، ان شاء الله تبقى الامور كويسه للافضل ان شاء الله، ان شاء الله ربنا يهدي البال ترجع للناس لبيوتها، ربنا يهدي البال ان شاء الله.
كيف الحياه بشكل عام في رفح؟
الوضع صعب جدا، صعب جدا للغايه، يعني الناس في الشوارع وكنا نعيش نفس نعيش اجواء رمضان زي باقي شعوب العالم، لكن للاسف حياتنا صعبه جدا وحياه الشعب الفلسطيني كله صعب جدا. فنسال الله ان شاء الله ربنا يهدي البال ترجع الناس لبيوتها، وان شاء الله ربنا يعيد علينا رمضان واحنا في احسن حال ان شاء الله.
شكرا شكرا يا هاني. Now we just talked to Hani Ashar, another resident from Rafah city. He's a resident here in Rafah, but he said that he's like all the Palestinians suffering from the consequences of the war, mainly as the Israeli attacks are ongoing in Gaza. We are now, he said that this Ramadan hasn't been lived by the Palestinians as normal as they used in during the previous Ramadan in the previous years. Now we are entering in an honorable school in Rafah, which is housing more than 30,000 of people, most of them from Gaza city. Once we enter to the school, we can see that it's dirty and it leaks from the clean, and most of the people here, as we did many conversations with many people here, they said that they are suffering from lack of water, of food, of medicine, and from the cleaning places for them. We will try to talk with some people here at the displaced. ممكن احكي معك؟ This man is, I think he's a displaced. ممكن تعرفني عن حالك؟
علي شبابي.
علي من وين يا علي؟
جاي من غزة.
قديش صار لك هان وحكينا عن الحياة هنا؟
زين هان ثالث يوم الحرب.
قديش عدد اولادك وكيف وضعك في الحياة؟
ولد وام سبعة انفار كلهم.
كيف الحياة في المدرسة؟
والله أنا شايف يعني تهجرت الناس من البيوت وهذا والأوضاع اللي شايفها يعني فوق الصعبة ودخل ما فيش الناس يعني الظروف تحت الصفر للكل يعني احنا في مسألة يعني من فضل الله بس الله يعوضنا.
كيف رمضان بالنسبة لك؟ كيف مر رمضان عليك حاليا أنت وأولادك؟
والله مر علينا كل شيء الحمد لله في الأول وفي الآخر طبعا، بس يعني الظروف ما عملناش مرت علينا. احنا اصلا من غير حرب، اصلا الوضع سيء جدا يعني اوضاع البلد وهذا سيء جدا جدا من غير حرب، ما بالك انت الحرب والوضع اللي صار هذا مع الناس يعني فوق الماساه. واللي عنده متصاب واللي عنده شهداء واللي 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 يعني حياتنا كلها ما قلت وهم.
طيب لحتى الان المفاوضات ما بين حماس وما بين اسرائيل ما زالت معقده في الوصول لاتفاق تهدئه في قطاع غزه.
احنا بالنسبه خلاص يعني من كثر الفتره اللي طولت هذه فقدنا الامل بالمصالحه وفقدنا الامل بكل حاجه. وبقول بس الحين بس بتودي الله هو اللي يقف معانا وبس. لكن غير هيك الفاضي.
لمين بتحمل مسؤوليه اللي احنا فيها؟
عمل المسؤوليه لكل القاده كله. لكل القاده. بعدين صوابنا مرميين ولا ماء ولا اكل ولا شرب ولا دنيا كله زي هيك يعني.
انت
صوابت من ثلاث اشهر بتكاتلوا الناس والاطفال يتكاتلوا عشان يجيب له شويه عدس يجيب له شويه غزيلة يجيب مش عارف ايش. المدرسه من يوم من اول رمضان لحد اليوم ولا حاجه سلموا الناس. هي بيا الكرتون سلموها قبل رمضان وبس.
من وين بتجيب اكل؟
ايه؟
من وين بتجيب اكل؟
هو ربك اللي بيجي هذا من جيب حلب الحمص بتاع زي هيك.
لا ما Actually, this man we did interview with him, he's he came from Gaza and he displaced his house inside the Gaza and came here to this school to live inside it amid the lack of all basic needs for them, for him and for his family, as he has children and all of them live in this school. He said that he blamed all the leaders or all the Palestinian leaders in Gaza. In addition, he blamed Israel of the current situation that resulted from the war between Hamas and between Israel. In addition, he said that he lost all his hopes to have a normal life, even if the war ends in Gaza, because he said that most of the Palestinians have been already suffering from poverty in Gaza, even before the war that started and that broke out in Gaza 6 months ago. As we see in our video, and as we mentor that most of the Palestinians here are now looking forward to having a ceasefire inside Gaza as soon as possible, just to let them at least to deal with their catastrophic situation in the coastal area.
Thank you. وجينا قلنا بدنا ناخذ نسكن تاني نجي على شققنا، لقيناها نازله الشقه. انا واطفالي نايمين في الشارع الحين، انا واطفالي 7 انفار معي، انا وياهم نايمين في الشارع. البلد هذه ما فيها قوي، فيش فيها استقرار، فيش فيها استقرار.
زي ما انتم شايفين الدمار الواسع اللي صار في المدينه. انا اخويا فقدته اول ايام الحرب، فقد الثاني تحت الانقاض مش معروف وين هو، يعني تقريبا 70% من الابراج راحت، والابراج اللي مش رايحه امه متعمدين ومكسروا فيها، يعني امر البرج هذا ولا البرج اللي جنبيه كله تكسير بشكل مش طبيعي تصلح، وين؟ فيش شقه، يعني فيش شقه كويسه، كله راح.
زي ما انت شايف هذا كان منتزه مش منصات صواريخ، هذا مكان منتزه، هذا ابراج كل برج 22 عيله. و24 عيلة أبراج، 22 وأبراج 24 بنسكن فيها. هذا منتزه وهذول الأبراج كلهم إرهابيين، كلهم طعون صواريخ.
المدينة حزينة، إيش بدك تشوف مدينة؟ ملهاش ملامح، فيش ملامح لها. كانت من أجمل الأماكن في خان يونس في الجنوب، من أجمل الأماكن في الجنوب قطاع غزة.
انه القسم هذا صغير اصلا 20 جهاز كله بيخدم، صار فوق ال 400 مريض على مدار الساعه، والمكاين تعبن كل يوم وعندنا عطلانات.
المشكله عندنا صار في قسم مرضى كلى، اول شيء مواصلات، مواصلات صعبه جدا. ثانيا الغسيل مش مزبوط، يعني ساعتين علاجات، فيش علاجات ولا في اي شيء، يعني علاجات شبه معدومه.
طلعوا على رفح ورجعوا مرة تانية على الزوايدة، فجأة انقصف البيت ما خلى ولا بني آدم. طب إيش ذنبهم هاد الناس؟ مدنيين عايشين ولا بيعملوا أي حاجة.